If you're working on a network where data communication is required between CAN FD and EtherCat, don't panic. I will show you an easy and fast way to connect these networks and get your data communications up and running. It's Toby again, and in this video I will show you an easy way to set up an EtherCat to CAN FD gateway. But you might be wondering, why do we even need to connect a CAN FD network to EtherCat? Is this a common data connection? Well, let's imagine we want to test and flash the battery management system of a traction battery in an electric vehicle. We would need to connect the battery management system, which communicates via CAN FD, to the automation system, which uses EtherCAT. But these systems can communicate natively, so we would need a device that can translate between these two. But how do we do that? Well, the solution to this problem is as simple as it can get. We can just add a gateway that acts as an EtherCAT device and translate the data to CAN FD. And our Ixxat CANnector is perfect for this. Its high flexibility means it is ideal for applications in which several bus systems are to be merged into a single device with its own processing power. And HMS provides the Ixxat CANnector with its own easy-to-use, Windows-based Advanced Configuration Tool, or ACT, which configures the Ixxat CANnector using drag and drop. Most use cases can be solved using ACT freeware. We will show you everything you need to know about this in more detail in a separate video. You'll find the link in the description below. With the Ixxat CANnector and the ACT, we are ready to set up the gateway, which I will guide you through with a few simple steps. For this demonstration, we will send one object from an EtherCAT PLC to the Ixxat CANnector and then to the CAN FD network. First of all, we have to make sure that everything is connected properly and that two CAN termination resistors are used in the CAN FD network. We have it here, over here. If you have trouble setting up the CAN FD, we have a separate video about this and you also find the link in the description. Okay, now let's start our advanced configuration tool. You can download it from our website, the link in the description below. To configure the EtherCAT to CAN FD gateway, first we need to create a new project. Therefore, go to File, New and select Gateway, since we want to build a gateway application. Next, you will need to select the product that you want to build the gateway application for. In our case, we will use the CANnector LE. In the next dialog box, we need to add the networks we want to use. First, let's add one CAN FD network. Click on the plus symbol, select CAN, and import the CAN description file. Within the toolbox, there are already some example description files included in the ACT. We will use one that represents the communication network of a car in this example, but depending on your individual use case, there are several other options. In the next dialog box, you can specify your CAN FD network in more detail, if needed. We will use the standard frame format and 500 kbits per second arbitration and 2000 kbits per second data rate. Now that we have configured the CAN FD network, we can add EtherCAT to the configuration. Again, click on the plus symbol and select EtherCAT. For this application, it's not necessary to select a description file. In the next dialog box, you can specify your EtherCAT network in more detail, but we will leave it at default settings since they work perfectly fine for our application case. Once the CAN FD and EtherCAT networks have been added and configured, we can proceed with setting up the gateway. Next, you can specify the project name, version, and the destination of your project file. In the following step, we need to identify the object, or in the automobile world, the signal that we want to translate from EtherCAT to CAN FD. To do that, click on the CAN FD tab on the left-hand side and select the signal. In this case, we choose to send the signal inertial voltage, which represents the voltage of the board net battery. On the right-hand side, we select EtherCat. The top selection represents all the objects that are sent towards the EtherCat network, and the bottom window represents all the objects received by the EtherCat network for this configuration. Since we expect to receive the battery voltage from the EtherCat network, we just simply use drag and drop. Selecting the CAN FD tab on the right-hand side, you can also see that the signal has been added to the output. That means that we have completed mapping the battery voltage from EtherCat to CAN FD. At this point, we could also map more objects and signals or include data logging, action rules or other cool stuff, but we will leave it as it is for now. Now we need to build the project and download it to the device. It is important to notice that upon building the project, an ESI file for your EtherCat PLC will be created automatically in your file directory. You will need to import this file into your specific EtherCat PLC, but we have already done this in advance. Next, click on Download Configuration to Target Device to download the configuration to the CANnector. Once this is done, click on Start and the CANnector starts running. And that's it! So let's quickly summarize what we have done. First, you have to set up the network connection properly. Next, you start the ACT, configure the networks and import your database file. The next step is to configure your gateway by dragging and dropping the required signals. Then you build the project and import the created ESI file to your EtherCat PLC. The final step is to download the configuration to the CANnector and start it up. How fast and easy was that? Let's see if everything is working as expected. Okay, as you can see, the lights on the Ixxat USB to CAN FD and the Ixxat CANnector are flashing green. This means the Ixxat CANnector is receiving the EtherCat objects, translating them to CAN FD and sending them to the CAN FD network, where the Ixxat USB to CAN FD receives the data. So everything is running perfectly. We hope you enjoyed this video. Please check out our many other videos for more information and advice on our other products. Thanks for watching, and if you liked this video and you want to support us, please leave us a like, follow our channel, and of course you can leave a comment too. Bye bye, see you next time.